Hey guys, this is Joshua Peterson, Peterson Electric. I was going to talk to you guys today about arc fault breakers. Our new code's coming up in 2014, and it should be adopted by June of next year with most cities. There's a rumor going that if we change these panels out, which is called a service change, and put on a new meter, which is required when you touch your panel, you have to update your meter, put in a slip sleeve if you have an underground fed. Well, it's now required that what I'm hearing is that we'll have to arc fault the breakers. So normally if we extend these circuits around the corner and put the service on the other side because somebody wants to move it or put it inside and flip it, or let's say that we have a house where we've got an old panel down in the landing of a stairway and it's got to move according to new code, or in a kitchen cabinet or in a bathroom. Well, if you extend all of these branch circuits, you now are modifying Article 210.12 under arc fault breakers, and they expect you to arc fault every circuit you touch. So I think it's getting to a point that since we're starting to extend inside of its own cabinet box where it originates, they're going to make us start arc faulting these things. So my suggestion to you, before they adopt 2014, you guys should probably try to get a service changing if you're looking at doing it. Typically, the rule of thumb is it starts about $3,000. People ask me all the time, how much is this going to cost? Rule of thumb, it starts at $3,000, but that's assuming that your panel and your meter are located next to each other. But that's with the permit, that's dealing with Excel and all their fees, or the power provider, I should say, as well as a brand new panel breaker, all of this that you see right here, and even your grounding as well that has to go here, and we also put in two ground rods down here in the dirt. So keep in mind, guys, that if you're not going to do the arc fault breakers and you don't want to do that, the only way to do that is to avoid a permit. I don't suggest doing that. I definitely suggest trying to get a permit with everything as much as possible, because it's good when you sell your home, as well as if you build out a basement, you won't want that square footage. Permits are there to actually protect the consumer. So we do suggest as much as possible, but just so you know, if we had to come in here and put arc fault breakers on this service, which this was about $3,200, this would have automatically gone up $600 more for the breakers. And in this case, with these kind of breakers, this might have been $1,000 just for the breakers, because we had a lot of two-pole 20 amps for the baseboard heaters. And if you end up arc faulting the circuits inside and they tie together, now you're dealing with more time and material to get those separated. And in this particular house, we had found some splices in the drywall, and some of the circuits were just tied together in one box. Stuff like that is impossible to find. So I don't know how they're going to amend that for the new code if they decide to go this way, other than maybe we come out with the testing equipment and find a way to set a sub panel with some new breakers. And we could tell you up front, hey guys, these circuits are going to set, but these ones won't set. Sometimes it's a little impossible, as you can see how all this bundles in. Sometimes we can't figure out what neutral and what hot. So it's going to be an open-end part of the bid where we can't really tell you what it's going to set or not. Because once we set the breaker and put the neutrals to that breaker, then we'll know if it's setting. And if it doesn't, we have to go in the home and start tracing out that side of the house to figure out how it loops. Anyways, guys, thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week.